is hot, the children are weary. But what shall they do? They need to film. The die has been cast. The lie has been collapsed. It's so windy, it's so sunny. Everything is working against me, but I need to film this. Okay, I need to film this. I have taken a pledge to work even with odds. There's the sun, there's the wind, and there's the zinc thing zinking. This looks kind of cute, doesn't it? It looks cinematic, it looks aesthetically pleasing, it looks artsy. This looks like an artsy, an art. Do you know, an art? Hey guys, hi. I really feel like I've been through a lot, like in the last few minutes trying to make this video work. I'm using my phone as a viewfinder, so I'm trying to look to see how it looks like. So yeah, hello there, my name is Martha Ehinome. Welcome to my channel. If this is your first time seeing the space, as I said, my name is Martha Ehinome. I do hope you stick around. Today I'll be answering questions from some of my followers on Instagram. So yesterday I put up a story and I put on a question sticker asking people to ask me questions, you know, and a few questions came in, so I'll be answering those today. How do I even do this? Do I like go to the... I really feel like I'm in some forest, man. It's like the zinc making noise, there are birds. I don't know what the heck that animal was, but there's just a lot, right? But we're here, so we're going to do what we came here to do. So about the questions, right? These are like the questions. I think I should go from like the bottom, right? I don't know if this should be the first question, right? I honestly don't know who I'm supposedly asking with all this right that I'm saying. But let's go. So the first question here says, what other movies have you featured in? Wura series made me know you. So I've been in a couple, right? I've been in Dear Bio, which I did in 2018. I think that was like my first major thing outside of school. Then after that, I did How About Macaulay Affair. Both films were by Imo Omoren. Then I've done a series, Our Best Friend's Wedding, season 2. Yeah, I was on that. I've done Riona. I've been on a couple like that here and there, right? Right. Our Best Friend's Wedding is on YouTube though, because people tend to ask, oh, where can I see these? Our Best Friend's Wedding is on YouTube. YouTube is free. You literally just have to use your data. So that's like the easiest one you can come across. Someone says, I love you. Oh, the first question, by the way, was from OM_Adebimpe. She also left another message that says, I love your smile and dimples. Thank you very much, Adebimpe. Adebimpe. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Then Extensions by Soso asks, what's your relationship with God right now? My relationship with God is a work in progress. That's all I can say, right? I think all our relationships are works in progress, right? That was very big. But really, I'm not sure what to say. I mean, I'm Christian, right? There are a couple of things that I'm trying to understand / figure out / I don't buy. But yeah, it's a work in progress. I love God. I know God loves me. I try as much as possible to be a good person, to be Christ-like, you know? So yeah, I think my relationship with God is good. But as I said, it's a work in progress because there are so many aspects in which I could still improve. I could still be better, you know? Yeah, so work in progress. Toluwa_Wumi. Hi, girl. She asks, how has been your experience as an actor in Nollywood? How has your experience as an actor in Nollywood been so far? More like it. I feel like a broken record saying this, but as I always say, I would say that my journey so far has been steady, not fast-paced, not slow either. I'll just say it has been, you know, it has been a steady ride. Like, I have progressively been given bigger opportunities that I'm very grateful for. I mean, I finished school 2016. I came to Lagos, you know, started to pursue more professional work in 2017. And this is 2023. I am on a Showmax project as a lead character or as a lead actor. And that's not a small feat. You know, there's some people that are like, oh, you've actually finished school 2016. Oh, you're actually not doing bad for yourself, right? I mean, could it be faster? Yes. I mean, there are people that have, quote unquote, blown. That's not my favorite word, but for this purpose, we'll say blown. Have there people that have blown, you know, faster or accelerated, you know, faster than I have? Well, yes. Is it enviable? Yeah, but I mean, this for the long haul, so there's no rush. There's no rush. Yeah. I don't know if what I just said particularly answers that question, because it didn't particularly ask of how my journey has been. She asked how the experience has been. I'll just additionally say that the experience has been great. I have never for once, you know, felt, you know, like quitting or anything like that. No. But yeah, there have been times that I have been sad, you know, not really because I'm not getting roles, because I believe a lot in my talent and I know that this is where I'm meant to be. So it's more like, I mean, when you're an actor and you don't particularly do anything else, you tend to depend financially on this. So when work doesn't come and you're short of cash and it just feels like you're in your house and you're not really doing anything, it gets frustrating. It's there's only so much that positivity can do, you know, for you at, you know, every given time. So yeah, there tends to be those moments, but it's been great so far and I'm really, really grateful. I'm really grateful. Sunshine_Iroowen. Sorry if I murdered your name. I'm quite sure I did. Sorry about that. She asks, do you work out? I do. Not intensely, though. And I tend to have seasons. There are seasons where I'm really consistent. There are seasons when I'm just doing light workouts so that I do not, like, relapse. And there are seasons when I'm just outright lazy. But most of the time, I am working out. Yeah, depends on my schedule or depends on my state of mind at that period in time. But generally, I do work out. I'm not a gym rat, but yeah, I do move my body from time to time. I very much am conscious of the fact that I need to move my body. There's a certain way I want to look like when I'm older. You know, I want to be fit. I want to be a 90-year-old woman that can still, you know, move. Yeah, so yeah, I do work out. International_local. I know who that is. Hi, Shegun. He asks, I used to think you're a shy person. How have you been able to overcome that? Then he also says, P.S. I love your smile. It's been refreshing from day zero and I'm proud of your growth. Thank you so much, Shigo. Right? Shegun was my neighbor in school, the university that is, in my second and third year, because I stayed in a BQ. About me being shy, right? I mean, I did study theater arts and all. So when it's time to act, like in school and everything, I know, oh, it's time to act, it's time to do my work. So I do that, right? But people outside of my department, and even my family members, I mean, I still have uncles still now that are like, I can't believe you're an actor. Like, used to be so shy, right? They used to even call me timid sometimes. But I don't know, in respect of the fact that I always felt shy and not so confident, and, you know, quite self-conscious, I have always known that acting is what I wanted to do. And I guess somewhere at the back of my mind, I've just always known that that would have to not be a problem. Like, that would not be a hindrance, like it's something I'd have to deal with. And I think generally, even outside of, oh, I'm acting, so I'm putting my shyness aside, I think generally in my life I have grown to be less shy. I mean, there's some, there was a time last year or so, someone was like, "You're shy, aren't you?" And I'm like, "Oh, crap, I thought I had gotten rid of that." So I'm still, this is so, there's still residue, from that trait. But I think I have just grown more confident and more, yeah, I've just gone more into myself. So I am less shy now. Yeah. Yeah. BG_001 says, "To me, how was your night?" "My night was okay, thank you." GiftMorgan_ says, "Please recommend your films. I really like watching you. I have mentioned those. I wouldn't want to repeat myself." Okay, the next question is from Tito_Ebabe_. I guess the proper picture is a lady, and Tito, I believe, is a lady's name. So I would say, she asks, "When did you realize you had a passion for acting?" This is a question I'm always very excited about because I really am sitting in like a very solid place of conviction. That was quite a sentence, you know, that this is where I'm meant to be. So I like to tell the story from time to time. So I knew that acting was what I was meant to do when I was 12 years old. Yeah, I remember the exact spot because I was in secondary school. I was in GSS 3. I remember people I was with. Yeah, like when it dawned on me, when I realized. I never say, "Oh, I decided to be an actor." I didn't decide. I realized I wanted to be an actor. I think I've somewhere in my brain, I had always known that I was going to be an actor. And it just clicked when I was 12 years old. You know, when you're in GSS 3 and then there's all that talk about, "Oh, so what class are you going to in senior secondary school? Is it commercial class? Is it art class? Is it science class?" You know, and then at that point in time, I was like, I don't freaking know what I want to be. I don't freaking know what I want to do with my life, right? And then that day, I don't even know what my train of thought was, but it was just like a light bulb went on, like just came on in my head. And I'm like, actor, I want to be a freaking actor. Goodness, Emmanuel, I see that she asked. I see that she asked three questions. She asks, and I read, "If 3x minus y equals 12, what is the value of x?" I don't know the answers to any of these questions. Goodness. Okay. Thank you very much for adding to the count of questions, but I'm sure you knew that I couldn't ask her these questions. Yeah. Yeah. Adegoke.aiki asks, "How do you stay motivated building your career as an actor? I know it's not an easy task. A big fan of yours." Thank you so much, Adegoke. And I really appreciate this question. Stay motivated. Like I said before, I'm very convinced that this is the path that I'm made for. And it's not even like it. Oh, I'm very convinced. So God shall say I should be here. And then you're, you know, grumbling throughout that period. It's acting is something I'm really passionate about. I'm very passionate about people, stories, things that make us human. And being an actor just helps, like, not helps, but it just like puts you in a position where you can be at the core of that, where you can tell stories, where you can be in people's shoes. And I think that's such an exciting thing. I'm also in this for the long haul. So just thinking about that, I don't know. I don't have reasons to, I guess be, what's the opposite of motivated? To be burnt out, not burnt out, but yeah, I don't have any reason to be the opposite of not being motivated. Right. Yeah. I sound really not smart right now. Sharon_ wrote to me. I see your tweets, by the way, Sharon. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for being such a fan of the show. She asks two questions, actually. The first is, how do you vent? I vent. So I have first of all, I vent to my friend, my best friend, especially, right? So I vent to him a lot, right? Then I talk to myself a lot too. So I tend to talk to myself and just like let it out. I also have an audio journal. So I talk there. I talk about my day. I talk about my thoughts, like my train of thoughts, like what's going on in my mind. I come to terms with things. I navigate my feelings, you know, with that medium. So I think that's how I vent. I also vent to God. Yeah. Yeah. So, you know, the people around me, God, my best friend, my audio journal when I'm, you know, saying things out. Yeah, that's how I vent. These are healthy ways. I don't break things. I don't destroy things. Yeah. Then the second question she asks is, how did you venture into acting? Let's say that a dog was crying. Dogs cry really weird, by the way. It's like, Jesus, I mistakenly stepped on you. I'm so sorry. And people around are like, what the heck did you do to that dog? Anyway, I digress. So how I ventured into acting? Yeah, I was saying that I almost said, I kind of already answered the question, but I realized that I only said how I, you know, came about the realization that I wanted to be an actor. Yeah. So how I ventured into acting. So knowing that I wanted to be an actor since I was, you know, in junior secondary school, I, you know, basically just took steps in the direction of that, right? So I wrote my JAM, I wrote my WAEC and everything. I studied theater arts for 4 years. After that, I came to Lagos. I did a musical first, Kakaduki musical. I did that pretty much after school. I finished school December 2016. I came to Lagos beginning of January, auditioned for Kakadu, started rehearsals in January and all of that. Then after that, you know, I served in Lagos, right? Then I just directed the same thing, to be honest, auditioning and everything like that. And then there was auditions.ng at that point in time, 2017, 2018-ish. They used to do like all these monologue challenges, not even just auditions.ng, directors, you know, saying, post in monologue and yada yada yada. I used to do those then. I won like 2 monologue challenges and maybe like 2 others or so. I maybe come up as the shortlisted people, right, that were selected, you know, those kinds of things. So I kind of gained followers from that. People kind of noted me from that. And then also people that I kind of knew personally also recommended me like for work and gave me work, thereby which was like my first major gig, right, after school, like film gig, right, after school, was by recommendation. Chimezie actually recommended me for that, right? And I'm so grateful. That singular act like really did a lot for me. Introduced me to Imo Omoren, and he gave me his, I've done like 2-3 other films with him since then. 2 films and a series with him since then. So, you know, just those things, just, yeah, that's basically how I ventured into acting. Yeah. Yeah. The next question is from me_na13. She says, how long is season 1 of Wura? I've been seeing a lot of questions like this. And a colleague of mine has mentioned that he tends to have questions like this also. And I'm like, are you guys tired or something? It's a telenovela. And if you check for how or what telenovelas are, it's like pretty long. So let's just say we're just getting started, right? I don't see the problem in saying, how many episodes it is. If you just do a Google search, I'm sure you find out. But I feel like you're like on the fence and you're like, I'm getting tired, so I don't want to be the bearer of bad news. So I just say hang around. Yeah. Sorry, I didn't particularly answer your question. _Abisola, then like a couple of underscores more. Is Wura the first movie you're acting in? We would like to see more of your movies. Thank you very much. That's really sweet of you to say. No, Wura is not the first series I've been on, or project. It's not the first acting project I've been on, but this is definitely my biggest. So yay. Glad you found me. Yeah. The next question is from Moses Panford. Will you call my number? Will you call me if I had your number? Because hearing your voice would make my day. Sorry, no, I wouldn't call you. I'm sorry. Or not so sorry, actually. Then Nene Wayo asks, hi, Nene. That's one of my friends, by the way. One of my close friends. Then she asks, when did you realize acting was it for you? And did you have to convince anyone to accept it? I think I already answered the first part of that question. I realized acting was it for me when I was 12. And I realized, it dawned on me that that's what I wanted to do in my life. And if I had to convince anyone, not really. My mom was kind of shocked when I first said it, right? But then I was like, one of my cousins, Sha, did theater arts. And her mom was like, oh, it's just a course, to be honest. I think that's what she just felt like. Oh, it's just a course because my cousin, he did it quite all right, but he's doing something else, right? So if she wants to do that, let her do it, that kind of thing. But my dad was like, theater arts, how do you do theater arts? And I remember the first time, because I mentioned it to her first, right? Or I think I and like some of my sisters were in the kitchen or something, so I mentioned it to her. So she knew about it first anyway. And then she just casually mentioned it to my dad when he came in the kitchen. I think he wanted to go out then. And he was like, why would you want to do theater arts, girl? That kind of thing. And then I went to open the gate for him. And then he was like, you better change that, your course, and yada, yada, yada. And then when I went to, because he took me to buy my JAMB form, you know, when you go to buy a JAMB form, and they'd be like, so what do you want to, what course do you want to study? You know, and I said theater arts, and then when we were leaving, my dad was like, you're still on this theater arts thing, Abby, you know. And since then, he actually never said anything about it. So to be honest, I think I didn't have to do any convincing, to be honest, right? I mean, I was always consistent in the things that I said. Oh, I want to do theater arts. I want to do theater arts. I want to be an actor, right? I study theater arts, going for auditions, getting gigs, just being on this path, really. So I think my actions were convincing enough, and thankfully they didn't stress me too much. And even if they did, to be honest, I'm pretty stubborn. It wouldn't really have been an issue, because this is it for me, right? So MZ_official asks, are you single? How old are you? Yes, I am single. I want to be I need to be funny and just, you know, give silly answers to the are you single part, but whatever, I'm single. How old are you? I'm 26 years old. My birthday is the 4th of July. I'm going to be 27 on the 4th of July. Get me a better present. Thank you very much. Oye Yolami. I don't know if these are two names. These are two names and I'm just like ruining it. But they say, please, I watched episode 32 Wura today. I'm so confused. No, I don't understand this. The same person asks, my regards to Uncle Dari and to Toby. Mm-mm. No, I don't understand this. I'm sorry. These aren't questions. Tessie_3D says, your skincare products, your skin color is amazing. I don't know if you can see it, but my skin is really breaking out. I did a skincare routine video on YouTube here last year, a couple of months ago, right? I think I was like maybe May, June, I don't know. But last year. And it was really working for me, but I changed some of my products. So I'm trying to go back to them in this coming month. So to be honest, my skin isn't really so great. But when I do have things that are working for me, I would make an updated skincare routine video. So good, watch out for that. Thank you so much and compliment though. I appreciate that. Where in Isaland are you from? Celebanti. I don't know what pronunciation is. I don't know if I murdered it in both my attempts. I'm really sorry if I did. I'm from Esan in Edo State, and in Esan I'm from Uromi. In Uromi I'm from Egbeli, Ubiaja. I think my mom is from Ubiaja. Or is that my dad? But I'm from Egbeli, Sha. That's my village. Say hi to my second cousins, my extended family for me. _Victory_Ovianwe says, when will Wura end? Oh, I've answered the question. Oh, or at least a variation of it. Oh, thank you. Oh. Yeah. Then Toluwani, the Tolu has double L, asks, how many episodes is Wura? It's so long and I know there's a lot we haven't seen. Yeah, again, I've answered that question. You guys are really curious, aren't you? But I'm glad you're watching though. I'm glad you're watching. And trust me, you guys haven't seen like anything, and there is so much more there are so many more exciting things to come. Trust me, you do want to stick around. And why are you even asking and being like, like, I know when series end, many times I see comments and people are always saying, oh, when is the new season starting? You guys shouldn't starve us. And now a series is going on for quite a bit. And you guys, human beings can never be satisfied. Humans. Slay_kids_Niger. Do you speak Yoruba or you just learned it because of Wura? I grew up in Ibadan. And every time I say that, people are always like, ah, you should understand Yoruba now and all of that good stuff. I grew up in a not Yoruba family. When mostly shielded in my primary school, we were told not to speak, quote unquote, vernacular. And yeah, we're pretty, I don't know. I just wasn't exposed to Yoruba. So I do know words, right? I do know words. I do know phrases and all of that. But my accent tends to come out weird, so I know how to beat around the bush to kind of say what I want to say, but it's like pidgin, probably a worse version of pidgin. So my Yoruba isn't great. but there are people here on set who help, you know, when you want to say something, when we're doing readings and rehearsals. You know, you say, oh, I want to say this in Yoruba. Or they say, oh, say this in Yoruba. You rehearse it and everything. Some of these things I do come up with myself because they're easy and I can say them, right? But yeah, there's also help because when I start to say the more complicated things, my accent goes to the left, to the left. Yeah. Okay, so the next question is, not a question. Tiffy or Tife with a Y _ says, I love you to me. I love you too. Thank you so much for loving the show and my character and everything. Thank you. Larry, I believe it's Larry. It's A-L-A-R-R-H-Y _Moores or Moore. Yeah, like Juliana Moore. Larry Moore's question is, do you have an intimate crush on any of your colleagues in Hollywood? No, I don't. Temi Luluwa Fosudo _Fosudo. One of my closest friends. I know it's going to be a weird question. Yeah. If I stage a kidnap and save you and get you stabbed and faint, wait. Tammy, leave me alone. Israel Lawal 5 asks, it seems you are an optimistic being, right? I don't know why you think so. I don't know why you think so. I'm not pessimistic. I'll say I'm more realistic, right? I usually have both versions of how something can go in my head. I hope for the best, but I prepare myself for the worst. Sylvia Ide asks, why acting? How long have you been acting? Why did you choose to be to me after reading the script? Why acting has been answered. How long have you been acting? I've been acting since 20, pretty much since I got into school because I studied theater arts. So yeah, as a student, I've been acting since 2013. So 2013 to 2016, I was in school. Then I came out of school. So 2017 till now, I have been acting professionally. Yeah. As to why I chose to me after reading the script, to me is a well-rounded girl. You've been seeing the story, right? The story, and it was even kind of easy to just like get an idea of what the world was and everything, because there is already a version of this in South Africa. So when auditioning and everything, we were advised to see the first few episodes of The River, which is what the South African version is called. And then I did that, you know, got accustomed to the world and everything. It's such an interesting story. It draws you in. It's crazy, so much madness going on. And it was just a world I wanted to be in. I mean, I'm an actor, I'm looking for opportunities to play people, to be people. And I really wanted to be in this world, this crazy world. So yeah, I hope I answered your question. Abisoye asks, how do you relate with God? I relate to God on a very personal level, right? I really believe that many Christians, especially the ones in Nigeria, are very, I don't know, I didn't grow up Pentecostal. I grew up Catholic, and I don't know if this supposedly helps to buttress my point and doesn't make it seem like I'm pointing fingers or shading whatever denomination. But you know, like this whole thing that you know, some Pentecostal people have, where it's like, oh, my pastor said the God of this, quote, insert pastor's name, the God of this person, I believe that relationships with God should be very personal. So I wasn't telling my friend like last year or something, you know, that when I'm praying to God, I pretty much say, oh, hi, God. Like, I think that God is my friend. God is the singular being, not just a person, but being, you know, who loves me so much, who cares the most for me. So I relate with God on a very personal level. I'm very honest with God. When I see some posts or, you know, some people who say, oh, do not lie to God, I'm like, how do you lie to God? Because I'm like, God knows everything. God knows me more than I even know myself, you know. So I'm very honest with God. I'm very vulnerable with God, and, you know, say, oh, God, I want to grow. I know that I can be way better, but I know that irrespective of my faults or the ways that I feel that I am not doing good enough, I know that maintaining a relationship with you in like every step of the way is so important. So I just, you know, all those things. I just, you know, say those things. And well, that's my relationship with God, man. Yeah. The next question, that's from Abisoye, by the way. I don't know if I mentioned earlier. And she asks later on. I know about Abisoye, by the way. Hi, Abisoye. The next question is, how can I make money like you? Girl. The next is from boy, with like BYOY underscore 990 asks, when will you release the next episode of Wura? Wura is released Mondays to Thursdays every week, guys, on Showmax, right? I know there are legal places you guys watch it. I've seen some screen recordings with funny thumbnails. So I don't know about those, but legally, where it should be, Showmax app, is Monday to Thursday. I feel like this video is going on for way too long, so I'm going to try to answer the questions a little bit faster. The next question, how do you feel about playing the role to me? I feel very, it's from Oluwa Bumi Grace 591, by the way. I feel very happy. I feel very grateful. A very constant feeling that I have is gratitude. I'm very grateful for this opportunity. Yeah, and I feel very privileged to bring this person to life. She excites me. Her journey, her relationships, her world is very exciting to be in. Yeah. Oluwa Bumi also asks, are you done with university and when did you school? Yes, I am done with university. I schooled the University of Ibadan. I finished 2016. She also asks, I love you and really admire your acting. Thank you so much. Thank you. Genoviva asks, what makes you smile? Hi, Jenny. What makes me smile? Many things make me smile. I mean, the general, not so quote-unquote deep things, or, you know, food, comfort, money. Money is such a nice form of happiness, which inspires smiling. What else? Being fulfilled, you know, getting closer to who I want to be, you know, getting opportunities, seeing my friends, seeing my family, seeing those around me, especially those that I love, do well. Have their dreams come true. You know, those make me smile. Those make me really happy. Yeah. I mean, there are other things, but those are the things that... Yeah, those are the things that, you know, came off the top of my head. Huzefa underscore says, where do you see yourself in the next 10 years? I see myself in 2033. I feel like all those date questions, like, so where do you see yourself in 5 years? Not married to you. Okay, where I see myself in the next 10 years? I see myself in Hollywood, I mean, amen, right? But not just that, I see myself, because I want to produce, I see myself being more established as an actor, having grown more in my craft, in my career, having produced a couple of projects that I'm really proud of, projects that I believe that we as Africans should be making and are capable of making. I see myself being way more fulfilled, way more comfortable in my skin, in my identity, in who I'm meant to be. And, you know, just taking up space. You know, taking up space. That's how I see myself in 10 years. I'm 26. I'm going to be 36 years old. I'm going to be very close to 40 years old. So, yeah. Yeah. The next question is from Joy Dragger. Hi. It's, what's an emotion that's difficult for you to navigate currently? That's a very deep question, right? So first of all, I'm an actor, right? I trade in emotions. They pay me to emote. So first of all, navigating emotions is something that I do for a living and something that I'm supposed to be comfortable with and all of that good stuff. But sometimes it's difficult to navigate. I think it's not. It was a few maybe months ago or something, I would say, because I personally right now, one of the personal projects, one of the things that I am really trying to work on, you know, is a very personal thing, which is my moods, right? I don't know if that's particularly answering the question, but it's my moods. I feel like I need to know how to manually like steer my moods to be more positive, to be more bright, joyful, right? I tend to have mood swings, and you know, when I'm in those spaces, I really hate myself, to be honest. And you know, a couple of people, you know, over the years have been like, when you're like that or something, or this and that, you know. So right now I'm really, you know, trying to steer myself in a different direction, you know, doing better. So yeah, there's that. So that's the only thing I can think of replying, to be honest, at this moment in time. And because we do not want to take too much time, we'll go to the next question. Thanks for the question though. Floyd, weird surname, hi Floyd, asks, what excites you most in a potential script? I think that the most exciting thing in a script is it weird for me to say the scripting? So, right, I mean, the story is something, right? How it connects to people, blah, blah, blah. But it's also the scripting. So it's more about the art of storytelling for me. And again, of course, there are also there are other things, you know, about the story, about how complicated it is, about the twists and turns and all that good stuff. But it's also the scripting. It's also the wit. It's also the art, the dialogue, all of those things. I think those are the things that excite me most. Yeah? Yeah. I hope I answered the question good enough. Excuse me. Nofisa Oyinlola asks, are we going to see more of you on your screen? Definitely, baby. As I said, I mean, this was a long haul. You're going to see me again and again and again. Okay? Okay. Hola Royce _ asks, what is the most beautiful girl doing right now? I'm answering questions. Hi, Dapsy. That's my best friend, by the way. Not that previous person. The person I'm about to call, Dapmola Ajo. Hi, bestie. He asks, do you think there is life in the universe besides humans? Of course, that's such a Dapmola question. Always something about existence and all of that stuff. I saw a video not so long ago that was showing, like, we on Earth, other continents, planets, sorry, like the Milky Way, and you know, the universe, other universes, and like basically saying how we're just like a tiny bit in, like, that compared to everything else that exists out there and everything. And I'm like, I don't know, to be honest. Like, some part of me thinks, to be honest, there could be, right? There could be other people just, you know, like us or something or different, you know. And to be honest, maybe there isn't. I don't know, I'm open-minded to it, but I don't know, I don't bother myself with things like that. I mean, I entertain the thoughts that, you know, there could be or could not be, but it's not like I know anything for sure. It's like I'm agnostic, right? What's the pronunciation regarding that? So I'm open-minded to either truths. I don't know. I don't freaking know, man. Ayomi _ Olaniron says, hi, can you please talk about your piercings? Plus, in my mind, I know we are best friends. Hi, bestie. About my piercings, I suppose you're probably asking, oh, how many they are and where they are. So I have April of 2021, about 2 years ago, I had just regular one, like the one they're giving at birth. Then I had additional ones. I have one here. I had two extra ones here. And then I have one here. So I had additional ones here and then here and here, right? And then I have one on my navel. So I have 7 piercings now. And I'm thinking of getting a few more. So yeah, those are it. Well, that's it about my piercings. I don't know what else I'm supposed to say. They don't mean anything extra. They're just pretty. Accessorizing and beautifying your body is nice. So it's something I personally like, right? So yeah, that's it. The next question is from Spence at Tohegbe. From the name, I suppose they're Edo. And they're asking, can you speak your local dialect? Not really, no. I do worse in that than Yoruba. I judge myself more than you can ever judge me right now. The person who has to question anybody else. So, yeah, that's that about that. Next question. Savannah Wheat asks, why do you look so gentle in Wura, not in real pictures? Because I'm acting fam. I don't know. What kind of question is that? I don't know what you even mean by not in real pictures. Because how do I then look in real pictures? Do I look like an Aguirre or something? Do I? Wait, really, do I? I know I don't, but I'm just wondering. So the next question is from Ego, the O is double O, so I don't know if it's Ego O David or the Ego is just emphasized. It's a guy's picture, so I suppose it's a guy. He says, mine is not a question but a comment. You played a superb and brave role in the movie Wura. It's a series though. I keep seeing people refer to Wura as a movie and I'm like, it's a series, man. But thank you very much. I really appreciate that comment. I've been seeing so many comments like that. I am really grateful. Really, really grateful for that. But last question, guys. The last question is from scene_dy_surprises. I believe it's a she. So she asks, are you from Edo State, mommy? Yes, mommy. I'm from Edo State. Like I've said like 50 times in this video. Yeah?
Yeah.
So that's it, guys. That is the end of this Q&A. My first ever Q&A. I'm so excited. I even just hope that this video is not like way too long and I have to cut things out. But yeah, at some point I was like, hey, these questions, they don't want to finish or something. I hope I was able to answer your questions good enough. It was really nice answering your questions. I hope this gave you some insight about me or more insight about me, who I am. And I do hope you hang around to witness, you know, more of my journey. Anyway, if you watched so far, thank you so much for hanging out with me. It's been a pleasure. Pleasure was said on purpose. I know it's pleasure. I don't know why I'm over explaining, but it's been a pleasure. It's been a pleasure and we have officially come to the end of this video. So if you've not subscribed to my YouTube channel, please don't forget to subscribe. It's quite important actually. Subscribe, hit the subscribe button, like the video, comment the things that are on your mind. Don't keep it tight to your chest. Comment, all these things help to grow my channel. Yeah, so I'll see you guys in my next video, which will be very soon. Fingers crossed. Bye. Mwah. This is such a nice angle. Feels like I'm shooting some music video. Abi Ashake, now maybe that yoga. Anina yoga. What was the other one? Organize. Every other day I organize. Wee! Penny, penny.